I was a pilot in the Air Force, and naturally when Sputnik went up, I covered that for Channel 10 in Albany, Georgia. And that's one of the reasons why I chose to come to Cape Canaveral.
And now 165 space flights later, 134 of them space shuttles, we're here for the 135th space shuttle. Now this will indeed end an era.
I've never been sick and had the privilege of covering every mission flown by American astronauts. I was working for our affiliate Channel 10 in Albany, Georgia, and had had a run-in with the Ku Klux Klan there. My crew and I had been out, and we were filming a meeting they had in a pasture, and they found us in the woods doing this film and, roughed us up in our equipment and all. And it was suggested to me by the police in Albany that it would be wise if I would relocate, that these guys were really after me. And so anyway, I relocated at Cape Canaveral, Florida, came down here. I was very interested in the space program. After working for a local radio station for a couple of months, I wrote a letter to William R. McAndrew, the executive vice president of NBC News, asking him why he didn't have a reporter here at this internationally hot dateline when the other networks did. So they called me on July the 21st, and asked me if I would cover a satellite launch. It was scheduled the next week. And I said to the desk at the time, Jerry Jacobs was the editor that had called me. I said, what about tonight? And he says, what do you mean tonight? I said, we have a Thor Able launching tonight, and we have a mouse called Wiki Mouse in the nose cone. Well, that was big news in those days. So anyway, they wanted me to cover that right away. So I did three radio spots and a TV spot the next morning for the Today Show on the launch of Wiki Mouse. And that started the whole thing here. I started as a stringer and stayed on duty here as a stringer for NBC for a couple of years and then made staff. And, of course, the first manned launch, I covered the launch of Alan Shepard on May 5th, 1961. I not only covered space, I covered Dr. Martin Luther King's campaign for NBC. I got to know Dr. King, who was a wonderful person, a wonderful man, and did so much good for our culture in the past century. So I've been here all of the time, raised a family, have grandchildren, great-grandchildren, owned the job for 53 years. I work out 5 or 6 times a week, feel absolutely great. NBC is the greatest company I could have ever worked for. I've been very fortunate. I've had nothing but the greatest bosses to work for and also the greatest people to work with.
So what we have learned from the space shuttle and the flights today is we have learned how to live in space, and that's very important that we keep doing that. Hopefully, NASA will be flying Americans again from Cape Canaveral, and I'm hoping that I'll be here to continue this from 166 to 167.